After 2 years of using the Klein CL800 multimeter in the field, I decided to do a thorough and honest review of its features, the theory behind its operation, and how to use it. Its features are many and relevant to the needs of appliance, HVAC, and other field technicians. In fact, current users of this meter may even learn about some features they never knew existed. Here is a list of those features, as well as some of those extended features in red. DC voltage function. DC, or direct current, is current that only flows in one direction. Here is the CL800 measuring the voltage of a battery. AC voltage, or alternating current voltage, is current that flows back and forth at a rate dependent on its frequency. Here is the Klein measuring the line voltage, which is 60 cycles AC. The CL800 is a true RMS meter. RMS, or root mean square, is a mathematical interpretation of a waveform that is the equivalent of that DC voltage in its ability to deliver the same amount of power to a resistive load. True RMS meters are designed to measure more complex waveforms and not just sinusoid. Here is a matrix of how well the CL800 fared while measuring certain types of non-sinusoidal waveforms as compared to other true RMS, non-true RMS meters in a digital oscilloscope. More information about this test can be found in the link in the description of this video. The CL800 fared well with sinusoidal and square waves, but did not do so well with full wave and half wave rectified signals. It might be important to note that the other meters did not do well with those signals either. Only the sigillant oscilloscope was able to come close to the calculated values of these waveforms. You will find more information about this in an article that is linked in the description of this video. The CL800 is a low Z meter. This function is very useful for field technicians. Using this mode puts a load on the circuit that you are testing. Normally, the input impedance of a meter is very high and will not affect the circuit you are testing. Low Z mode, however, puts a load on the circuit because it has an input impedance of about 3,000 ohms. Low Z can be used to detect ghost voltages and compromised voltage sources. Ghost voltages are those that appear that shouldn't. They appear on parts of a circuit that have no current flowing through them. They are often induced by proximity to other wires via inductive or capacitive coupling. In low Z mode, ghost voltages tend to disappear, most often letting you know that they aren't relevant to a circuit's function. Sometimes you'll even have leakage current through a high resistance that supplies a voltage that you don't expect. Although technically not a ghost voltage, the effect is similar. Compromised voltage sources, on the other hand, are generally those with an upstream or internal resistance that precludes them from supplying the required current. An example is a wall outlet that may read okay with a traditional voltmeter, but fails or decreases in voltage when you try to draw current from it because of loose wiring or connections. Here's a use case for low Z. We have an electric dryer that runs but has no heat. The L2 voltage line has a loose connection in an upstream junction box in the order of about 500 ohms. We first measure it using the standard AC voltage mode and then use the low Z mode to measure it. Both methods effectively use a voltage divider to give you a reading. A voltage divider is when two or more loads in series splits the supply voltage in a way that is proportional to the resistance of each load. So let's take a look at that voltage source being read by two different modes. This example shows a difference in the voltage that you would read using a traditional mode versus low Z. As you can see, the low Z mode is the only mode that reveals a problem with this voltage source. Details on how this works can be found in the link in the description of this video. You can even use the low Z meter to tell you the value in ohms of the upstream loose connection. In our example, the upstream loose connection was 500 ohms. There is a formula that you can use to determine that value if you were in the field and would like to give a follow-up electrician details about the voltage source failure. More information on this can be found in the link in the description of this video. AC current is measured non-invasively using the meter's clamp. Simply clamping around a single conductor will allow the meter to read AC current flowing through a wire. Like most clamp meters, the CL800 uses a current transformer where the subject conductor is a one-turn primary winding, which allows the meter to provide a reading that is directly proportional to the measured current. This is because all wires with current flowing through them are surrounded by a magnetic field, the strength of which is proportional to the current. Using the clamp meter, you can even measure low value currents at the bottom end of the meter's range by looping the subject wire around the clamp a number of times that you want to multiply the current by. For example, if you want to read 0.45 amps, you can get more accuracy by looping the wire three times, then taking the reading, which in this case would be 1.36 amps, and dividing by three. DC current. Traditionally, DC current would be tested by breaking into the circuit with your meter. The CL800 has the capability to read DC current non-invasively via the clamp using a Hall effect sensor. These sensors are capable of measuring static, non-changing magnetic fields and are ideal for interpreting DC current. All wires with current flowing through them have a magnetic field surrounding them regardless of whether the current is AC or DC. Again, the strength of this magnetic field is proportional to the current through the wire. This is a very convenient way to measure DC current. Like with AC current, you can use the multi-turn method to measure DC current with the Klein CL800. Measuring resistance with this meter is self-explanatory. It has a good range, measuring resistances all the way down to 0.1 ohm and up to 60 mega ohms. Note that when you turn the multifunction dial to resistance, it defaults to continuity, which means it will not read anything over 50 ohms. In order to measure resistance, you will need to press the select button after using the multifunction knob to select resistance. Multimeters like the Klein CL800 inject a constant current through the device under test. That current multiplied by the resistance equals a voltage that can be directly interpreted and displayed as a resistance value. Continuity. Continuity mode can give you an audible beep of resistances of less than 50 ohms. It is a default resistance mode of the meter. Again, be careful to press the select button to get out of the continuity check and to measure resistances of greater than 50 ohms. Capacitance. This mode is handy for measuring anything from 0.01 nanofarad or 10 billionths of a farad up to 6,000 microfarads, which is larger than most anything that you will find on appliances, HVAC systems, and most power supplies. It can measure all types of capacitors, including common electrolytes, but does not measure ESR, equivalent series resistance, which is another important metric of electrolytic capacitor health or failure. Capacitance is measured by injecting a current source into the capacitor and measuring the resulting voltage across it after a given amount of time. Frequency. This mode measures in cycles per second alternating current anywhere from 0.001 Hz for one cycle every 1,000 seconds all the way to 500 kHz, 500,000 cycles per second. It can measure different waveform types such as square, rectangular, and triangular. Frequency measurement is accomplished in multimeters by using an internal frequency counter as well as a cleanup stage called a comparator to smooth the waveform like a sine wave out into a clean rectangular wave for accurate measurement. Here's a meter measuring a 1 volt, 1 hertz square wave. Here it is measuring a 10 volt, 100 kilohertz square wave. And here it is measuring a 60 cycle, 10 volt sine wave. Duty cycle. Duty cycle is a percentage of a waveform's high state divided by the total period of the cycle. Here is a meter measuring a 10 volt 60 cycle rectangular wave with a 30% duty cycle. The same waveform at 90%. Diode and semiconductor test. Diodes and other semiconductor junctions like those in transistors pass current in only one direction once their forward voltage drop is exceeded. In order to do this, you must have a voltage that is higher than the rate of forward voltage. The DC voltage across the device under test is then measured and displayed. This is what makes up a diode and semiconductor test inside a multimeter. The maximum forward voltage drop that a Klein CL800 can measure is 3 volts. Thus, any semiconductor junction, which includes most diodes except microwave diodes, most bipolar transistors, and many types of LEDs that have a forward voltage drop of less than 3 volts, can be tested with this function. Zener diodes that use a reverse voltage drop are not good candidates for the diode check unless the reverse voltage drop is less than 3 volts. The Klein CL800 multimeter measures temperature in both Fahrenheit from minus 14 to 1000 degrees and Celsius from 1 degrees to 548 degrees using a common K-type thermocouple and an adapter. A K-type thermocouple is a junction of two dissimilar metals that, when heated, generate a voltage that is proportional to temperature. Contactless voltage detection can be accessed by pressing the NCV button while holding the tip of the clamp near the conductor under test, and the red LED in front of the clamp will illuminate when line voltage is detected. I found this feature to be very sensitive, so you may not be able to easily distinguish which conductor has a live voltage on it if the conductors are in close proximity. This feature detects the presence of an electric field that exists in reference to the person holding the meter. It will only detect line voltages, not neutral or ground. Neutral and ground are assumed to be at approximately the same potential as a person operating the meter and will thus not be considered live. Backlight and work light. This feature can be accessed by pressing and holding the hold button on the top right of the meter. Both the work light and the backlight come on simultaneously. The backlight makes it easier to read, obviously, the display in low light conditions, and the work light provides a small amount of light when a flashlight is unavailable. Natural two-headed operation can be accomplished by attaching one of the meter leads to the holder on the top right of the meter. This allows you to hold the meter and the lead in one hand while holding the other lead in the other hand, which means you don't have to find a place to hold your meter or hang your meter while using it. Pros. This is a very rugged meter built to take a beating. It has about every conceivable function needed for field technicians. It even has extended features that current users may not even know about, such as a DC clamp meter, non-contact voltage detection, and duty cycle measurement. I did find, with almost every function of this meter, that its accuracy fell within its claimed specified range. Cons. The CL800 only uses its clamp for measuring current. It would be nice to have inline current measurement as well, since that does have its place. ACRMS is not that accurate for measurement of half and full wave rectified waveforms. To its credit, most other true RMS meters that I tested weren't either. Only an oscilloscope was able to accurately measure these waveforms. Resistance setting on this meter defaults to continuity, which only works about 50 ohms, so you have to be careful if you want to measure resistance. You have to press the select button in order to get out of the continuity mode. The CL800 has a plethora of features oriented towards the needs of field technicians. It seems to hit all the bases and then some. It measures AC true RMS voltage, DC voltages, AC and DC current through its clamp, resistance, diode check, continuity, temperature, frequency, capacitance, duty cycle, and more. Its accuracy is sufficient for most applications. It's a great all-around meter for field technicians and seems to be one of the more popular ones in use. If you'd like to purchase this meter, there's a link to it in the description of this video. Thanks for watching.